कारण है यार
bags were able to complement the collection that she had on the show today. And the sensibilities are very, very Indian in nature for us in Caprizi, and that's what we look at when the designers that we try to associate with, but with a slightly modernish Western sensibilities. Perfect match, I would say, between Caprizi and Payal Singhal today. Thank you very much for this.
Payal, your collection has an Uzbek word,
yes.
The theme behind your collection. It means confluence. I can't pronounce the word Uzbek. Perfect, Koshilish. So if you can tell us a little bit more about your design ideology, your thoughts, and the collaboration in, as a whole.
So when we were asked to do the collection with Caprizi, I was, I kind of went through all the other shows, and they were usually more of a Western flavor. And of course, we do Indian clothing. So we thought that, you know, it would be really nice to bring in some, kind of deeper tones and richer fabrics and see how Caprizi would work. Because actually in a day-to-day life, you would carry the bag to a wedding or to a party or on a date night. So we wanted to kind of show those variations of that on the runway. Koshilish or Confluence, as what our collection was called, is basically the journey of kind of art from Uzbekistan all the way to India, through Persia and Afghanistan, and from the Mughals to India. And every time it goes to a different area, it kind of merges with the local arts and crafts, and you get a completely new form, art form. And such beautiful motifs and embroideries and textures come out of those, what we call now collaborations. But in those days, it was just naturally, people from this village would come to that village and their arts and crafts would kind of merge. And there's some interesting things which are in our press kit about which kind of embroideries used to be called what in different areas. I won't get into that. But what is beautiful is that when the Mughals came to India, they kind of mixed with our Indian culture in terms of our Maharajas, Maharanis, and our Indian art and architecture, and gave birth to a completely new form of art and architecture, which you see as what we call today Mughal art, but it's got a lot of Indian influence. So basically, that's in a nutshell what the collection was about.
Thank you so much. And Moni, you look wonderful. So if you can tell us a
Thank
little bit
you.
What it felt like walking.
First of all, congratulations on having an amazing show. Needless to say, the clothes are so beautiful. Also, my association with Payal, we go long back. We met each other 5 years ago, and I was a pest, and I told her, I have to walk for you. And I was waiting for this opportunity, and it's like a dream come true for me, and I couldn't be happier. And the best thing is, it's Payal's birthday. It's such an auspicious day, and this is my first Lakme Fashion Week walk, and it's with her. So I feel really grateful and thankful. So thank you.
Thank you so much. I'm going to open the floor for questions. If anyone has any questions now. No?
Personal, casual and saris and lehengas, actually. I really, really feel nowadays everybody is quite aware as to what they should dress as. And so they are all very well turned out. But if you ask me, my favorite, a style icon that I look up to is Audrey Hepburn, Catherine Hepburn. And in India, Rekha Ji. I love saris. I'm a Bengali. I have grown up on saris. So yeah, they'd be my absolute favorites. Yes. I don't know, maybe a leggings and a tee and a high-waisted pants with a crop or skirts. I love wearing skirts and stockings with boots. So, yeah. Depends on the... I think you should dress up according to the occasion. you know, wearing a denim and a tee to a wedding is not cool. So you should wear a sari or a lehenga, and so on and so forth. So. जी मैं बहुत ज़्यादा नर्वस थी मैं स्टेज पे ठीक थी बट शो से पहले और उसके बाद में मैं बहुत शिवर कर रही थी एंड आई गेस इट हैपन्स बिकॉज यू नो एज अ परफॉर्मर यू यूज टू डांसिंग और सिंगिंग और एक्टिंग सो देर इज एन एक्टिविटी दैट यू डू हियर यू जस्ट हैव टू काइंड ऑफ शी गेव मी अ टिप राइट बिफोर आई वॉक शी सेड रोमांस द कैमरा फॉरगेट अबाउट एवरीथिंग एल्स लुक एट द कैमरा एंड रोमांस So I tried following her instruction. I don't know how successful I was, but it helped. Kuch nahi, focus. Focus and try to look nice and graceful and yeah, that's it.
So Moni is wearing a lehenga. It's an organza. It's got full zardozi work. And what I love about the motifs that we took was it's got this Rajasthani kind of a motif, which is inspired and made with like Mughal embroidery. Because zardozi is technically more of a Mughal embroidery. So you get that real mix in it. And I actually had kind of envisioned her like a Persian bride. And the dupatta is actually a one-sided jacket, which you belt. So it's like a hands-free, it's a dupatta, but it's actually a jacket. It's a one-sided jacket. And we had a little contrast in that, and that's in Georgette.
Spectacular. I mean, yeah, I would not have noticed it if you hadn't pointed it out, but it looks stunning. And they all, like you said, it's a perfect collaboration made in fashion heaven. So thank you all so much. Thank you. And we hope to see more from you soon.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We're not able to one-on-one.